The Effects Browser is our shortcut to be able to explore the over 4,000 presets that we have available to us in the Continuum package. But it's more than just a way of looking at presets. So join me as we take a look at the Effects Browser. It's time to see how the Effects Browser is going to work in Adobe Premiere Pro. And as with all the golden threads of Continuum, this works in exactly the same way in After Effects as well. Now, the Effects Browser is by far the easiest way to take a look at all of the presets we have available for a particular clip. So if I come in and I do Bcc video glitch and apply this to my car park effect, we can see we have lots of different presets available to us. But unless you know the exact preset you're looking for, this can be a bit tricky to figure out which one you actually want. So instead of looking at the drop-down menu, I'm going to go into the Effects Browser. And this is a viewer 100% designed to look at our presets. So the first time we play anything through, it can be a little bit choppy as the video caches through. But the next time we play it through, it's going to play back in real time. And once the video is cached, as we update the different presets, we'll find that we have a faster playback anyway. Sometimes some of the effects are going to be quite heavy and slow down on the first run. But again, the next time as it's cached through, we're going to be getting that real-time speed. So this is a great time to find an effect that actually works for us. And as we're clicking through, we can also see down in the bottom in the history here, the last presets that we've clicked on. So as we're clicking through and we find one we like, but maybe one of the other ones is a little bit better, we can click through the next couple and go, actually, I want to go back to the one that I was at before. What was that? Instead of guessing, you just go back through your history until you find the one that you need. In the viewer itself, you can speed up the previews on some of the more render intensive effects by taking the resolution down from full to half to even down to a 1/16. This may not give you a great idea of this particular effect or any effects with fine detail, but it can give you a good idea about movement and color if that's what you're interested in. We'll keep this at half for now. Coming back to the top of our viewer, we also have these compare modes. So we can turn the compare off, or just as if we were using the compare in the effect itself, we can compare things side by side or do a compare split. And the split also has the wipe line, and you can see this effect in a particular area. So that's a nice way of doing before and afters. I'm happy with that. I'll just turn the compare off again and hit apply, to then apply that preset back into our host. And obviously all of the presets are still fully customizable. So if I don't want something like the block damage, I can turn that off right here. Coming over to our next effect, the Bcc Effects Browser is so important that there's actually an effect called Bcc Effects Browser. And I'll apply this to our second clip and I'll launch our Effects Browser. Now, in contrast to the one that we saw earlier, this doesn't just have the presets for one particular effect. It actually has presets for every single filter that we have available in Boris Continuum. So this is really useful if you're searching for inspiration, or if you know you want something that's something like a film style, but you're not quite sure what effect is going to be most suitable for your particular piece of footage, then you can come in here and try and get a little bit of inspiration. So in this case, I might like Iceman or the actually vivid amber skin in the two-strip color. So I want to apply this to my clip. If we look in the bottom right-hand corner, you can see that we only have a close button. We don't have apply and close. And that's because the Effects Browser filter is just that. It's just the browser. So if we wanted to apply that effect now, we would come back in and we'd go Bcc two-strip color, bring that over the top, and then we'd find the preset that we wanted, either within the drop-down menu or in the Effects Browser proper itself. And in this case, it was the vivid amber skin that I liked. As before, we can mix this back or do whatever changes we need to make to get our filter working for us. And that's a quick overview of how we use the Effects Browser found in Boris Continuum within Adobe Premiere Pro. If you found this video useful, then remember to hit the like button. For more ways to master Boris Continuum in Adobe, subscribe to the Boris FX YouTube channel and check out our other tutorials. If there's something missing, then let me know in the comments below. My name is Ben Brownlee from Boris FX. Thanks for now.